on the previous episode.
Hi guys, what are you doing? You silly little geese. I shall ride you to Mexico.
And now, continued.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. Extinct animals, extinct species, extinct things, basically. Now, I finally managed to complete the Paleo Island challenge, and what I suggested at the end of the last episode, wherein basically the animals I was giving away into the wild weren't ones that are classically part of the expansion pack, that was the problem. So I sat down, I waited, my Styracosaurus grew up, my dodo, I got a dodo, I gave that away, and the gar, or whatever those things were called, the horny, because they have horns, not because they're horny, those mammal things. So we finally managed it anyway, so we're going to move on to the second extinct animals sort of campaign mission, all in a day's work. And this time, ladies and gentlemen, and we're all very excited about this, I'm not going to screw it up. Got to keep in mind what I said a minute ago, that basically extinct animals, for the purpose of the game, as in how the game recognises it, does not include ones I've added via the mod. Now that you've shown you can build extinct exhibits and keep animals happy, you get to build your own zoo from scratch. There are many new challenges that come with building a zoo with extinct animals. Finding extinct animals to adopt, using your extinct research lab and keeping all your animals happy can be difficult. Can you keep up with all these challenges? I think I can. Your job is to build the best park you can. Keep your animals happy, fed and healthy, and your guests entertained, educated and spending money, because we love money, don't we? To start, you need to acquire 3 extinct animals from different species and meet their basic needs. Go beans! Okay, so, again with the peacocks. People suggested to me that people called them peafowls and peacocks in America as well. The game's calling them peafowl. I'm just leaving this out there, the game calls them peafowl. So whatever you do in America, the game disagrees with you. Maybe the game's not American. That's not, oh, like this. Why he's got 3 different types of path? Don't know, but whatever. First things first, let's go ahead and add some thingamajiggies. You know thingamajiggies? We all love thingamajiggies. Like food stands and all that kind of, that's not a good location. Oh no, we've already got food stands. Do we have a restroom though? Do we have a restroom? People wish to urinate occasionally. People are crazy like that, what can I say? Put that there. I quite like the idea this of having bigger paths. I don't like that though. Otherwise, I don't like that being there at all. I can go there, and we'll move the bin. Quite like the, yeah, I was going to say, quite like the idea of having, like, wider paths, because, paths, because it kind of gives you more room to just add extra things in, and stuff. Anyways, let's have a look. Now, I do have to stick to the extinct creatures that would usually be in the game, otherwise it won't work, and to my recollection, not a single one of these lovely fellows here is actually part of the game by default. What we're going to do is we're going to go on a little mission to gather our own DNA instead of spending money. So, boop! I don't know what's happened with this, but, oh, crikey, why is it starting back here? I've got this new fancy fossil finder thing, and it's awesome. I feel like a scientist. So on Styracosaurus again, that's fine and dandy. It'd be nice to get something new, like a Leoplerodon. Let's just go on a nice little trot around the park and see what we can find, eh? Not forgot. Okie dokie. Ooh, an ammonite. That'd be nice. Wouldn't that be nice? That'd be delightful. This is what Indiana Jones would actually... You've received $7. Oh, crikey. I don't know if this is still recording. I hope this is still recording. Java popped up asking me to update. Nobody likes Java. One day I'll update Java just so it stops asking me every 4 seconds. Would you like to update Java? No. If I wanted to update Java, I would have done it 9 months ago when you first started asking me. Java, please go away. Thank you. Not that I'm bitter or anything, but Java. Okay, I appear to be finding many different creatures, but not really any of the same type. Eustriptospondylus is doing okay. That's getting somewhere. I love this little matrix thing. Science. I like how I don't have to stand there digging. I summon, essentially, from the heavens, from the mystical architects in the sky, paleontologists, even, just this. It's like Thor with his hammer, but I use a pickaxe instead, basically. Did anyone else watch that film? I would totally watch that film. Instead of Thor, it's the archaeologist or the paleontologist. And he just uses a magical pickaxe to dig up dinosaur bones and then creates the dinosaur bones in his own Jurassic Park. I would be all over that. While we're here, like I said in the last video, lots of people have suggested the Jurassic Park mod. Yeah, I can't find a single link for it. All the links are dead. If you happen to have a working link, feel free to leave a comment with it or something or other, because it looks really good and there are like specific Jurassic Park models and stuff as part of it, but I, at this point in time, I simply cannot use it. You know, it's not possible. Hello! I think we've done a good sweep, but I'm still missing a full creature, basically. I don't have anything. We're going to do this. This is my new tactic. We spin around, and that's going to work beautifully, as you can see. Oh. Getting there. We're nearly a Leoplodon, which would be awesome. Mainly because of Charlie and the Candy Mountain. Rawr! It's a Leoplodon, Charlie! God, that video was like my childhood. It makes me feel old thinking that video was part of my childhood. It's a Leoplodon, Charlie! If you haven't seen that video, you haven't lived. It's really annoying nowadays, and nobody actually likes it anymore, but still, it was magical at the time. Basically, Charlie the Magical Unicorn and his friends, well, I say friends, they meet a Leoplodon, and they're going to ask the Leoplodon for the way to Candy Mountain. And the Leoplodon tells them the way to Candy Mountain by going, and I quote, "Rawr!" And they're all, "He shows the way to Candy Mountain!" And Charlie's all like, "No, he didn't, because he didn't say anything. He's a Leoplodon. He's went barg, and that's not directions to Candy Mountain at all. But we need one more piece, and we can make a rarg. Come on, Leoplodon. That's not a Leoplodon. Leoplodon, why do you have to have such a big skeleton? Why can't you have a nice little skeleton like me? What we on? Come on. God damn it. At least we're knocking out a lot of pieces for a lot of things. Ammonite's doing okay. I'm pretty sure I've been down here, so why are there suddenly a million pieces? Velociraptor. Feel free to continue adding lots of new creatures and not quite letting me finish any of the ones I already started. That is That's fantastic game. Absolutely fantastic. Ramporhynchus. Why can't it just be called Dave? If all dinosaurs were called Dave, everyone would remember more dinosaurs. Dinosaurus. We'll get there, ladies and gentlemen. We'll get there, I promise. Come on, be good to me. We're nearly there. If we get that or the Leoplodon, that's two creatures already. See? As soon as we got these, it'll get a lot easier. And this way I'm kind of learning what creatures are by default part of the Extinct Animals expansion pack, because obviously any creatures not part of the Extinction Animal Pack you won't find by doing this, because they've not added the fossils and stuff like that. Come on, just give me one. Just let me start. A Balor. No. Not what I wanted. Did I miss one? Yeah, apparently I did. What have we got? Hooray! Leoplodon. We're going to finish our little route around, because we are going to need three creatures at the end of the day. And we're getting quite a few in this kind of area. Oh. So easy to miss. So ridiculously easy to miss. Miragia is quite cool looking. That's like a big sauropod with spiky bits on it. Hooray! One more to go, ladies and gentlemen. One more to go, and we can go and make our three lovely jubbly extinct creatures. Ramporo. Don't know if any of them are particularly close. Velociraptors still got a while to go. If you want to be an archaeologist, this is the kind of thing we're going to have to deal with, okay? I need to get... Where am I meant to be going for this one? Is it in the flower beds? Crikey. Cryptoclidus. Not even heard of most of these. Ichthyosaurus. Hooray! Again! Brand new creature! Just please give me the same one for once! Protoceratops, we're nearly there. We're nearly there. There's so many creatures. There's something like 36, I believe, new creatures added to this game, if you include the killer penguin and one of one that you have to unlock. So it's not that surprising that I'm finding many, many different creatures during this process. But no T-Rex or anything like that quite yet. Come on! Come on, game. Ammonite's nearly there-ish. We're getting there. We're getting there. This is science. Science sometimes is dull and requires your heart. Hooray, we're done. Protoceratops, Leoplodon, and that other thing. Crikey, that took a while. Right. So, we're going to go and we're going to put together some fossils like so. We're going to start with the Leoplodon because Leoplodon is awesome. And huge, basically. Is that going there? Yeppers. Right, let's start. Crikey, this is going to be oddly difficult. Interesting. Okay. Is that the head? That looks like the head to me. I think that goes down there. Now, we need a neck kind of bit. That's a fin. So that would probably go somewhere. It would definitely go somewhere. Can't deny that much. No, okay, we're gonna put that away. What's this? Maybe. No. This is oddly difficult. Maybe it's not. Maybe I'm just silly, but it feels difficult. Bam! There we go. Cooking with gas. Now that, as far as I can, no, that doesn't go in there. It needs to be something that's going to go like that, looks like it to me. That kind of hooks. Nope. Maybe it's that. Nope. I think it's that. Bam. Alright. Cooking with gas. As opposed to cooking with, not gas. Okay, so we need like one that's got a really thin bit. That looks likely to me. Yeppers, there we go. Ow! Hooray! It's a Leoplerodon, Charlie! And let's go ahead and create ourselves a Leoplerodon. Oh, crikey. Right, okay, I'm ready, ready. Boom, science, boom, science. Boom, science, boom, science. You feel sciencey? I feel sciencey. I don't actually want to do science. I spent all day bloody doing exams and science. I'd like to stop doing science, if anything. We're going to go ahead and make one more, because you can't let them... Oh, you have to wait anyway. Okay, let's make the biome then. Let's set up a nice house for our Leoplerodons. Biome. Boop. Boop. Now we can make... Oh, crikey. We can make a tank, but I'm not big on my tank buildings, as you've seen in the past. Actually, what we're going to try to do, because I've never tried this before, and I like trying things, is we're going to do a Leoplerodon. We're going to try to combine like the tank with the fence, if you know what I mean. Although this doesn't really make sense. It's what we're doing anyway, I don't care. You know the boss of me. So we're going to start from... There's a nice chain link fence. Okay, we're going to start with a chain link fence. I'm going to go along there, down there, down there, and just about there, I think. And then same with that one to there. I've got no idea if this is going to work, but we're going to give it a go. Acrylic tank wall, and we need to put this... Yep, mayhaps. Is this working? This feels like it might be working, I guess. It doesn't feel like it's working. Because that should be filling up with water right now. And it's definitely not. okay. Why can't I... Hello? Game. Okay, there we go. Okay, let's just put a tank in for now. And then let's try and maybe put a fence over the top of it, I guess? Nope. You know, I've got no idea how to do that. I know you can do it, but I don't know how. So I'm going to leave that for now. That's fine. Anyway, let's go ahead and... do what we do and knock that down as low as possible. Just realised, last video, I said I didn't know how to figure out how to raise the floor of the tank, and I've just, unless I've gone crazy, I've just figured it out actually. So let's raise that up. What we want to do is go into our sculpting tool if we can, and maybe... No, I was kind of hopeful that was going to work, but it's definitely not. Maybe if I raised the ground up beforehand, I guess. Let's try that. What we're going to do is, this is just an experiment, really. I'm going to raise the ground here. I don't really care about doing this. Somebody explain that to me, because I don't really know what I'm doing. And let's put some stuff in there. Lovely jubbly. We need some enrichment. So, clam bubbler, I believe, and a boy with fish. And, yeah, nice little kelp bed in the corner. We're going to need one of these things so my peeps can get on. And reef, okay. Boop! Lovely! Lovely, lovely, lovely. Let's go ahead and raise this down quite a lot. It's about there, maybe. And should be able to go ahead and get our Leoplerodon into there. Mr. Leoplerodon, join me over here. Thank you. I'll leave you there for a second while we create a friend. I can't leave him in there on his own, can I? It would be a little bit mean. Beep! Boop! 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 Bloody Nora, I wasn't on my mouse then. That was quick movement. Splendid! You come join me over here. Nope. Keeps rotating me, I'm not really sure why. You lovely chaps in there. And unbox, and unbox. Now, they are babies, but eventually they'll grow and they'll be huge and awesome. Can you see them? I think this is quite a cool height. See them on the top. I'm going to have to put a fence path down here. But you can see them on the top, and when they go under, you'll be able to see them quite well. This is pretty cool. If I lower it any further, I assume... Oh, crikey. Oh, they're not a fan of that, are they? Let's not do that. Did I put that too high? No, if anything, that's better. Awesome sauce. I like that. That's alright. I don't mind the tank. Let's go ahead and put a path there. Just to make sure people can actually get to it. Like so. Is it sand, I guess? Or is it this? Whatever, I don't care. And we're going to stick with using this asphalt stuff as like... It's like where the guys go. Is that helpful? That doesn't feel that helpful. Let's have a little... Are they going to... Oh, look at a little babby under... I want to go in the sea. Whee! Bob. Hi, guys. Oh, very cool. Very, very, very cool. Hello. I assume this is a custom texture because it looks... better than I assume it would. But whatever. Awesome. It's a Leoplerodon, Charlie! Right, let's go ahead and make another creature. We're going to go for not the Protoceratops, because we've had the Styracosaurus before, and I don't actually know what this thing is, so that would make more sense. I'd like a mammal. We've not had much in the way of mammals, but by the head, it doesn't really look like one to me. Crikey. Okay. That is the back, isn't it? So that's definitely going to go up there. That looks kind of like a hind leg to me. Sort of. You can kind of see a hind leg type area. That goes there. Ah, this one's dead easy. Dead easy. There. Yeppers. Yeppers, 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 yeppers. I'll leave that there for a second. Oh, crikey. Was that that one? Yep, there it is. There, and... There! There's a gap in it, but apparently that doesn't matter. This kind of looks tiny to me. Am I crazy? It kind of looks like... It kind of looks like a compy, you know, type thing. Boop! Boop! Science! Boop! 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 Little man in the corner is so happy with me. It is! Oh no, it's like a... It's like a tiger, it's like a raptor. What's it like? Is that reef? Oh, it likes reef. Ooh, I can have fun with this one. I like the reef. Let's make another fence-a-roo then. Can I use little fences? I want to use little fences when I can. I can. Assume by the fact that he's saying I can use little fences, that if I do choose to use little fences, nothing's going to die, basically. Like, they're not going to escape and kill everybody. This is my general hope in life. Okay, we're going to put that down there. Down... There, down to there, down to there, up to there, and up to there. Okay, let's go ahead and... Where's my cellar tool? Nope. This. None of these are, you know, relevant to the biome, so... May as well bring a little cash in, to be honest. This is kind of how I sustain my purchases in... Nearly, nearly, nearly. God damn it. in the first campaign mission when I had to buy a lot of things, I just basically did this and sold all the trees. Okay. And biome, reef. Very cool. Don't know why the reef is making me so happy, but it really is. Meow. Meow. I should have put these two together. That would have been awesome. I'm going to find a way. If I can find a way, I'm going to stick those two together. But until then, let's just basically have a nice little beach area down there. And then some shallow water, which completely ruins the look of my beach. Oh, no, maybe my beach area awesome. Okay. Dokie, that'll do. And food bowl, water bowl, some coral, yes. Awesome. Awesome! And a small reef rock, yeah, we can go for that. Very cool. A little shelter there. And I think that is pretty much our lot. I'm going to research. They tend to like balls. Balls, they're big fans of balls, generally speaking. So we're going to make sure we utilize the balls, basically. There's no really other way of putting it. We're going to utilize the balls quite well. Let's put him over there. Let's go ahead and make him a friend. Or her a friend, as the case may be. I'm not really sure. This man in the corner is absolutely fantastic. He is my favorite human being in existence, including myself. Boop, beep. Boop, beep. No! No! Oh. Oh well, it'll be quite cool to have like a big one and a small one anyway, I suppose. If I'm gonna have to, I don't really have a choice anymore, do I? Let's put him there, and let's unbox the both of them. Now they are only babbies, so they will get bigger. I've got to remember that. They're like little raptors. Hello! Oh, they're so tiny! Hello! Very bubbly, sirs. Nice little... Oh, this is really nice exhibit. I'm really happy with this one. Not to toot my own exhibity horn or anything. Oh, no, that's adorable. Oh, no, I can't keep looking at that. That's far too cute. Right, we need to put a bit of path in there. I keep forgetting how you make paths. What do I want? Do we go for dirt path? What does dirt path look like? We're going to just go ahead and replace the pathing because I'm really not a fan of this stuff, whatever it is. I'd like it all to look the same. It's going to bug the hell out of me if it doesn't, frankly. Lovely jubbly. And down there, and then across there. Quite hard to make it curve, you know. It's weird. But that looks cool. I'm happy with that. Alright. I think we're going to end it there, because I can't remember when I started this video. So, it could be too long or it could be too short, for all I know. And what we've done well, we've got two new little creatures that I've never seen before. I think these guys are both in the pool, swimming around. It's too much, guys. I'm pretty sure they're drowning, because they are walking and not swimming right now. But, yeah, they're definitely drowning. But they seem okay with it, so that's fine. Next video, we're going to make ourselves a Protoceratops. Set up our final dinosaur exhibit, probably over here on the left, and then see what else the game's going to throw at us for the rest of the campaign challenge. Like I said, we're going to go back to the idea where one campaign, one freeform, one campaign, freeform, one campaign, freeform, you know the drill. Kind of keeps things very exciting, and you have to keep things exciting in Zoo Tycoon, much like the bedroom. My speakers are dirty. Yeah. Okay, until the next episode, thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Please do like and subscribe, and I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love as always, bye-bye.